Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Bill. We'll be in the Advanced Player's Guide for this one. We're continuing the Archetype class build series. We're on the Rogue class. This one will be the Investigator archetype. So let's read into the Investigator and see what talents of the Rogue you'd be giving up to get whatever boon the Investigator is going to give you. Not all rogues work against the law. Investigators use their skills to serve the law, often in the employ of nobles or in their pursuit of noble causes. In some cities, cabals of investigators work for rulers or bureaucrats, but often an investigator is a free agent who pursues whatever mysteries come across her path. Of course, not all investigators serve the law. Crime lords and guild masters often have squads of investigators serving their own nefarious purposes. Follow-up. An investigator can roll twice on any diplomacy check made to gather information, and receives the information for both results. This takes the same amount of time as one check. If the lesser of the two checks reveals false information, the rogue is aware of it. False information is not revealed in this way if the people she questioned do not know it is false. This ability replaces trap finding. So you would gain knowing if it's false information, you'd gain two pieces of information from the double roll. You lose the ability to find traps, or at least whatever bonuses that's given you for this. But if you're in an investigated heavy campaign or game, or even an adventure in a one-shot, this would be pretty useful. The following rogue talents are what they recommend you take to complement this archetype. Let's see, it starts coax information, fast picks, follow clues, hard to fool, and minor magic. The advanced talents they recommend is the Hunter's Surprise, Slippery Mind, and Thought Re-examining. So you only get one ability if you want this one and you lose trap finding. So my take on it's the same as any rogue that loses trap finding. I like traps in my games, so if my players would want to play this, they can. Just know that there will be traps, and you're ability to not find them could hinder you a whole lot. That said, I also like the idea of traps that can be disarmed without having to be the rogue, so, or at least navigated without having to be the rogue. So I think I need to do a video on traps again here in the future. Well, let me know what you all thought about this archetype in the comments below. Until we all game again, guys.